We'll finish our study of monosaccharide reactions with osazone formation, and while this reaction was of historical importance for the elucidation of monosaccharide structures, it's no longer useful that way. However, the chemistry is very closely related to chemistry that takes place in food science, where amines combine with sugars to make a variety of different sugar derivatives, and so I still like to include this reaction in the study of its mechanism. Starting with D-glucose in the pyranose form, in the presence of three equivalents of the molecule of phenylhydrazine, whose structure is shown here, two nitrogens are bound together, we end up making the derivative known as the osazone that's shown there, which has two hydrazone functionalities, phenylhydrazones at C1 and C2. There's also the third equivalent of phenylhydrazine that ends up making aniline, that's the structure shown here, and then a molecule of ammonia. You can notice in this reaction, and our mechanism will have to explain it, that there's an oxidation state change at carbon 2. We had one carbon-hydrogen bond, and in the product, the osazone, has none, and so at carbon 2 there's been an oxidation reaction taking place. As far as the initial steps of the mechanism, I won't work out all of these details, but you should be able to write the formation of phenylhydrazone. Phenylhydrazone is the reaction in which phenylhydrazine combines with the carbonyl, in this case the aldehyde, to make the hydrazone derivative. And that reaction mechanism is very closely related to imine formation, and I would encourage you to just stop the recorder and go ahead and make sure you can write the steps involved in the transformation of the aldehyde into the hydrazone, because that's really the first step in osazone formation. Starting with the pyranose form of glucose, we can open it up into the open chain form, then the carbonyl at position number 1 can generate the phenylhydrazone derivative seen here. At this point, we have an acidic hydrogen at the alpha position, and that hydrogen can be tautomerized through a process that looks very much like that base-promoted isomerization of glucose. And so what we're going to do, general base, general acid catalyzed process of tautomerization, we can then turn that around and make the carbonyl at position 2 by protonating the position carbon 1 to make the carbon 1 now picking up a second hydrogen. And so we have a CH2 at carbon 1 and a carbonyl at position 2, still having the nitrogen bound to carbon 1. I know the mechanism is kind of complicated, but if you keep going, what you can do is make another hydrazone at position 2 with a second equivalent of hydrazine, and that's exactly what happens. So these tautomerization reactions are followed by a second hydrazone formation to generate this intermediate that's shown here. What happens next is a base-promoted process of fragmentation at position 1, and you can see what's going on there. We're basically breaking that weak nitrogen-nitrogen bond as our leaving group. It's a type of beta elimination where we're generating now a new carbon-nitrogen double bond with loss of the molecule of aniline. And so here's where our aniline is formed in this particular step. So at that point, we now have the possibility of making a molecule of ammonia. That can happen by hydrolysis of that carbon-nitrogen bond on position number 1, and that's exactly what happened. We basically have an imine functional group which loses ammonia and makes a new carbonyl at position 1. That carbonyl can now take and make a hydrazone with another equivalent of hydrazine. Hydrazone formation at carbon 1 concludes the reaction mechanism and generates the osazone of glucose.